Hi children, we are into globalization. Our topic is impact of globalization in India. What is globalization? Globalization is the process of rapid integration of countries. It is a major change that occurred across the globe in the late 20th century. This has economic, political, as well as cultural dimensions. What has been the effect of globalization on the lives of people in India? Globalization has been of advantage to consumers, particularly the well-off sections in the urban areas, that is, the rich people. There is the greater choice before these consumers, who now enjoy improved quality and lower prices for several products. As a result, these people today enjoy much higher standards of living than was possible earlier. You can clearly observe here the situations before and after globalization in India regarding transportation and infrastructure is concerned. Globalization has never considered agriculture as priority. It has only targeted urban areas and city people and service sector in particular. So clearly you can see here, before and after there is not much difference in the rural areas, but there is a lot of difference in the urban areas. And you can also observe in the lifestyles of the people through these pictures. Has globalization been uniform among producers and workers? Among producers and workers, the impact of globalization has not been uniform. It was not same. Firstly, MNCs have increased their investments in India, which means investing in India has been beneficial for them. MNCs have been interested in industries such as cell phones, automobiles, electronics, soft drinks, fast food, or services such as banking in urban areas. These products have a large number of well-off buyers. In these industries and services, new jobs have been created. Also, local companies supplying raw materials etc. to these industries have prospered. Secondly, several of the top Indian companies have been able to benefit from the increased competition. They have invested in newer technology and production methods and raised their production standards. Some have gained from successful collaborations with foreign companies. So they have benefited the most. Moreover, globalization has enabled some large Indian companies to emerge as multinationals themselves. Tata Motors, Infosys, Ranbaxy, Asian Paints, Sundaram Fasteners are some Indian companies which are spreading their operations worldwide. Globalization has also created new opportunities for companies providing services, particularly those involving IT. The Indian company producing a magazine for the London-based company and call centers are some examples. Besides, a host of services such as data entry, accounting, administrative tasks, engineering are now being done cheaply in countries such as India and are exported to the developed countries. IT products and services are exported to many countries, from India to America, England, Australia, Japan or Korea. So, there are some positive as well as negative impacts of globalization in India. Let us see first positive side. There are a variety of products available in the market today. Due to globalization, development in infrastructure has been rapid. Boost to service sector has become true. Foreign currency and foreign direct investment in companies has boosted companies. Global form of modern business has become true. Rich are getting richer day by day. But there are negative points too. Exploitation of workers, less importance to agriculture, small producers are suffered and lost, uneven benefits of development, local artisans and handicrafts are at a loss, local and small cultures are marginalized and looked down upon, poor are getting poorer every day. So that was the lesson, children. Let us see how well and how far you have learned. First question: what are the consequences of globalization in India? Second one: globalization is a boon as well as a bane to the Indian economy. Comment please. Third one: globalization will continue in future too. How will India be after 20 years from now? Fourth one: why do you think MNCs such as Ford Motors set up their plants in India? Fifth one: name and locate some countries which are outsourcing jobs to Indians on the outline map of world.